If we rewind a couple of weeks ago in Perth, when you did your knee, can you just talk us through the incident and what you felt and what happened?
Yeah, it was pretty surreal. Obviously, I hadn't played AFL, proper AFL game for a while. Went to put body on Matt Taberner in a marking contest and then saw Michael Walters float across the front. Yeah, I think left knee just kind of, I guess, buckled a little bit. And yeah, I knew straight away. I'd done, in my right knee, I'd done a few of the other ligaments before. And just they talk about you feel a pop when you do your ACL. I just felt a little bit of a pop and a bit of instability, and I felt my knee shift. Pete Bequay, who's absolute legend, he was a bit rattled, which kind of got me emotional. I could tell that, he's kind of rehabbed all my other injuries and looked over me.
So you're saying our head doctor, Peter Bequay, who's dealt with these things over his whole career, he was emotional about it because of what you've been through?
Yeah, he was kind of trembling a little bit. It was quite surreal. It was just like, I'm sorry. Mum and Dad had come down with Neil Connell, and kind of they came up to me, and straight away, Mum was kind of waiting back because I think she was pretty emotional. And just said to Dad, "Yeah, it looks like it's my ACL," and yeah, it was pretty emotional. It was a bit of a group hug because I guess this is the thing, like your families go through it all with you. Yeah, that was hard, and then calling my girlfriend Emily, that's probably the hardest part. Because just down the other end of the phone, like it's really hard for her. She's like, last year she wasn't in Sydney when I did my knee, and she really struggled with that. So my first response when I saw Mum is, "Mum, can you give me the phone? Like, I need to call Em and tell her that like this has happened, but like things are okay." So it's a grieving process because something's taken away from you. So in that initial like 20 minutes, half an hour, you're just thinking, "Gee, like, okay, everything's just turned on its head." Like all I was thinking about was playing the next 22, 23 weeks plus finals, and just. So excited, and now like things have changed, but you gain a bit of perspective on where footy sits in life.
Before the game, you'd just come in off the track after the first warm-up, and in the rooms there were a couple of little kids in uniform with runners on, and without a hesitation you made your way over to those kids to go and make them feel comfortable and introduce yourself and tell them that, you know, because they were clearly a little bit nervous about running out onto Optus Stadium. I couldn't help but think, like, with all the stuff that you would have had on your mind having not played footy for so long, first game back, that just showed how much of an amazing bloke and what a great character you are. You just always have that mind for other people.
Well, it's actually, I know like why I would do that, because I guess having it, I don't want to get too emotional here, but because it's been taken away so many times, footy, every time I play, especially AFL, like I just really appreciate it. Like if you ever watch me run out through the banner, I turn around and look at the whole stadium, smile, just think, this is incredible. Round 10, 2004, Geelong played North Melbourne at Kininya Park. And for my 8th birthday, Dad had given me the opportunity, like the experience to run out with the team. And I remember that time I sat with David Johnson and Stephen King. They were injured at the time in a player's stand. I remember them offering me a hot jam donut. And they were just so nice to me. So I was like, and that still resonates with me, like 15 years later. So I thought, if I can do that to like a little kid, albeit I'm no superstar, but just to make them feel like welcome. Like you wouldn't say David Johnson is a household name, but I remember him and I respect him for that.
For that, yeah.